in-depth plan, check out the links in the description box below.
All right, so I've been doing a lot of reading, trying to figure out my elbow problem. I've been having a lot of elbow pain on squats, and it's a kind of a come and go, ongoing issue that comes and goes. And I think I've kind of figured it out, or I've kind of narrowed it down to some issues that might help you if you're suffering from elbow pain. One video that comes up quite often, because if you Google on YouTube, there isn't a whole lot of videos, I guess not particularly with squats, heavy squatting and elbow pain. It's very common in forums, but you don't see a whole lot of videos about it. So I thought I'd make a little bit video series. So this will be the first video of the series. Talking about squats and elbow pain, the one thing that I've figured out is, what I think I've figured out for me specifically, is that the way I load the bar is my poor shoulder mobility. Now remember that when it comes to the body, especially in the shoulders, if you have very bad shoulder mechanics, if you have tightness in a specific system, other parts of the system are going to have to make up slack. And sometimes that part of the system isn't able to move the way you want it to, and it causes an issue. And so let me elaborate on that. What that means is if your shoulder isn't rotating good enough because you have tight chest, tight pec minor, tight shoulder rotation, not good enough external rotation, not good enough internal rotation, when you get to below bar back squat, especially if you go super low, and you don't have the shoulder mobility for it, what ends up happening is your wrist or your elbow have to make up the difference. And what ends up happening is you kind of use these tissues or these joints to kind of compensate for what you can't do in the shoulder. And it creates this kind of bad loading pattern. And let me just show you or just demonstrate what I mean. And kind of how I used to set up, or I guess, because this is my first, I'm taking a deload because of this elbow pain. It's kind of sucks, but how I used to do when I set up for the squat is I take kind of like a medium. I won't go super wide, I won't go super narrow, but what I would do is I get the base of my palm, or maybe the base of my wrist to start it off, or maybe the base of my palm right here to sort of position myself ideally. Then I would squeeze my shoulder blades together, and then I would get underneath the bar. Now just doing this already, because of my tight shoulders and probably my poor positioning, is causing a lot of elbow tension. In this case, because the area is irritated already, I feel elbow pain. Not elbow pain, but definitely some tightness, and if I push into it, it hurts. And then what I would do is, if I was healthy and I wasn't in pain, what I would try to do is I would try to scoop underneath the bar and dig my back underneath it. And it hurts. It hurts my shoulder more than my elbow right now, but I don't want to irritate my elbow. But what I would try to do is I would try to dig really hard here, because this shoulder has difficulty with internal external rotation. What ends up happening is I try to use this force in this wrist to kind of drive my shoulder blade back and get this shoulder blade to rotate, externally rotate, so my elbows can get pulled forward, the armpit forward position. That makes it so that I can get the bar in the right spot. But what happens is, because I don't have that mobility or I don't do it correctly, what ends up happening is I get this valgus force, elbow kind of this direction of force going this way. And what that does, it causes a lot of stress here in this medial tendon, sort of a golfer's elbow or medial elbow pain. And so this is kind of what I figured out. I've been kind of practicing racking the bar on my back, and this is kind of what I've noticed. If I take a full grip, right, so a closed grip, and then what I do is I get underneath the bar, but what I'm going to do is I'm actually going to spin the bar as I get underneath it like this. So I get underneath it like this. There's not a whole lot of elbow pain because my wrist stays in neutral and I'm moving with the bar, and I haven't quite got underneath the bar yet. So my elbows are going forward, my whole body's going forward. So I'm pushing my elbows forward, my armpits forward, and then getting in the spot in my back, maybe a high bar or a mid bar position. And then what I do is I squeeze my shoulder blades together even tighter and then unrack the bar. And interestingly enough, there is no elbow pain. So what I'm beginning to realize, or what I'm going to teach with you in this video here, is that what happens is that if you can keep the wrist neutral without any excessive force in the shoulder, where the shoulder is able to rotate, you're not going to have issues. It's going to minimize the valgus force, or what I think is a valgus force going this way. Because, I mean, you got to think about it. This is my bicep here, my elbow joint, and how it's supposed to move this way, right? It's not really supposed to move this way or this way. In this case, if I have the bar right here, right, what's going to end up happening is I'm breaking at the wrist, or let's just say I keep it straight as hard as I can, even with a wrist wraps to make sure that I can get good position for low bar for powerlifting. What ends up happening is this even though that this is straight, I'm still pressing really hard on this wrist, super hard, and it's getting this issue. And so what's happening is the force is still translating into here. And maybe the first few times it's not a problem, but as you get stronger and you lift more weight, it becomes more and more of an issue. It starts to show up that you're using a off-label tissue for something it's not designed for, or it's not designed to carry those loads. So what ends up happening is when you initially get on the bar, you basically load the tissue first, or the elbow joint, or the medial tendon first, which basically starts the occurrence of the ongoing problem, which will translate into more issues down the road. So, see you in the next video. Hope you got some information. Leave a comment below if you have a question, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
I wanted to take a moment to tell you about a program that I recently invested in. It's called Fixing Elbow Pain by Jed and Rick. I've searched on the internet, articles, read lots of stuff, and constantly keep seeing the same mediocre videos, or videos that are helpful but don't really solve my problem. That's one of the main reasons why I've created this video series on fixing elbow pain related to heavy squatters, because I couldn't find the exact information. Although my video series will probably help you and will give you better ideas on kind of how to prevent elbow issues and set yourself in the right position, there's still a lot more to know, like working on tissues and just understanding routines and stuff. That's why I bought this program. Fixing Elbow Pain was a really good program investment for me, because it helped me just essentially understand all the avenues of kind of what to take care of, because it's not just medial elbow pain that's the problem. It's also lateral epicondylitis or tennis elbow that happens in some of my clients. You soon learn that it actually has a lot more to do with overall movement pattern, and everyone has different movement deficiencies. So the reason why I'm recommending this is that it's very comprehensive, and it's actually very difficult to explain all this in a 5 to 10 minute video. And also there's like books, there's lots of videos, and it's basically a whole program that's totally worth the value if you are suffering with elbow pain. But anyways, if you'd like to learn more, take a look at the links below. Comment below if you have a question. Thanks for watching. There's one more thing I forgot to mention. Full disclosure, I am an affiliate for this program, so if you decide to purchase this product through my affiliate link in the description box, I will make a commission from it. It does help support my channel. I was actually thinking about making my own kind of rehab program for elbow pain and really putting some good information together into a product. And then I came across this, I bought it, and it was like $30, and it was freaking worth well above that cost, simply because there's just a lot of information, there's lots of drills, there's lots of exercises, there's lots of explanation of what's going on, and it's totally worth it. So if I'm endorsing something that I bought, I'm endorsing something that I believe in, because you know the truth is there's probably a way where you can essentially go through all the videos online and kind of read a bunch of articles and maybe figure it out. This actually just kind of puts it all together for you in a very high quality package. But also be sure to check the rest of this video series on elbow pain and squats.